Happy and enchanting day, dear children. I welcome you all to the English corner. Children, today what we are going to learn is, what is this? What we are doing is dialogue writing. Yes, you are going to write a composition. Okay, dialogue writing. Now, shall we? Yes, what is dialogue? Dialogue is what characters in fiction says. It is how characters express themselves verbally, right? Orally, verbally. Usually in conversation with each other. It might look like this, right? What do you want for dinner? Jack asked his friend John. I don't know, you decide, John replied. This is how a conversation looks. So now we are going to write dialogue writing in our composition note. Are you ready with your composition note, dear? Yes, very good. So what does dialogue look like? Dialogue usually appears in quotation marks, as in the example given above. So last slide you saw an example, right? So it was in quotation. However, some writers get creative with their punctuation. So, some writers, what they'll do is, they will create their own punctuation marks. For example, some use an M dash to notate a line of dialogue which look like this. Can you able to see a dash here? So, this is what is called M dash. Okay, the same dialogue in the previous slide, I showed you what you want for dinner has to be in quotation, right? This is what is quotation marks. And see here, I don't know, you decide. This is closed quotes and this is opening quotes, right? Can you able to see that? Now, in this next slide, how the author used this punctuation is an M dash. So, this is what? Dash, M dash. Now, what do you want for dinner? Jack asked his friend. The same dialogue with the M dash. Some writers don't notate dialogue at all. So, for example, Nobel Prize winning author Joe Saramago treats his dialogue just like the rest of the narration, like this. John asked his friend John. Jack asked his friend John, what do you want for dinner? And John replied, I don't know, you decide. So there is no quotation, no M dash, nothing. Okay, the author who did this was a Nobel Prize winner. So it is understood that all these are narrations, all these are dialogue writings. Okay, all these are conversations. Right, if you put your dialogue in quotation mark, note that punctuation like periods, question marks go inside the quotation mark. Everything has to come inside the double quotes, right? Inside the double quotes. What are the things? Question mark at the end of the sentence, full stop at the end of the sentence, exclamation, whatever you are writing in a sentence, whatever quotation marks you are using in that particular sentence, everything has to come within double quotes. If a character is quoting someone else, you put the quote inside a single quotation marks. So there is a difference. If you put your dialogue in double quotation mark, everything has to be inside. All other quotation mark has to be inside. If a character is quoting someone else, you put the quote inside the single quotation. Okay. And see here. When I asked Jane about it, her response was, within the double quotation, they are using one more. Just not sushi. Just not sushi. When I asked Jane about it, her response was, just not sushi. So everything, so quotes within the quotes, right? So one dialogue is there. In that dialogue itself, you are including one more dialogue, right? Then you have to Notice that it should be in single quotes. Right, what is the difference between dialogue and exposition? So what is exposition? What is a dialogue? First, you have to understand that. In fiction, there are two types of narration. One is dialogue and one is exposition. Dialogues refers to things that the characters say in the story. Exposition refers to the sequence of descriptive narration. Descriptive in the sense, like a big paragraph. But dialogue will be small, not very lengthy, not a paragraph. Will be very small. So, dialogue refers to things that the characters say in a story. Exposition refers to a sequence of descriptive narration, like a paragraph. So, unless you are writing a film script or a stage play, children, now you are in the basic stage. So, I want you to know the importance of dialogue writing. Okay? How a film script is made. So the writer will imagine before shooting the film, they will write script, isn't it? How that script was made. So they will imagine, right? They will visualize. The same way I want you to imagine, unless you are writing a film script or a stage play, it's best to maintain a balance between dialogue and exposition. So try breaking up long passages of exposition with the short dialogues. Even a sentence or two, one sentence or two sentence enough. Okay, only that will be refreshing. If you are talking more, then it will be boring, isn't it? So if you have a very long section of dialogue, it is good to insert brief section. Brief in the sense short. Brief sections of exposition to keep your reader grounded in time and place. So they will stay with us if the dialogues are precise and sharp. So dialogue writing between two friends who have met after several years. This is a question. Take your composition note, dear. Take your composition note. See, actually, when I was searching for conversation, when I was searching for dialogue writing, nearly 110 slides I took. Okay, that much of information was there. So, before talking about all the information, let us write the dialogue writing in our composition. Then we will move on to the rules and regulations that has to be followed that you should know. Right, then you go on searching for the dialogue writings in your net, right? So take your composition note, write which side you will write the question, baby? Left side. Left side, you write a dialogue between two friends who have met after several years. Okay, in your right side, write the dialogue writing on the top and the exercise number. Right, today's date. Start writing your dialogues. Right, first is Divya and Smita. So, Divya, hi Smita, what a pleasant surprise. I am so glad to see you after so many years. Children, you can write your own dialogues also. You can change your name, the name of the conversation also, right? Boys prefer to write boy's name, isn't it? So you can write your own name. So Divya and Smita, I'm using. You can use any other name also. So hi Smita, what a pleasant surprise. I'm so glad to see you after so many years. Smita is seeing. Me too, Divya. I feel like ages. How are you? And what are you doing here? Divya is saying, I'm good. I got married 3 years ago and live here with my husband and son. Smita says, that's great news. I too moved back to with my husband from Pune 6 months ago. Divya, so where do you live? I live in Kharg. Wow, we live very close. We should meet sometime. Yes, we should. How about this weekend? Sounds great. Why should you should bring your husband along? I sure I will. Okay. So here, I sure will seems to be wrong, but great authors are using these sort of sentences. You can write I sure I will. Okay, that will be great, isn't it? Sure, I will. Right, Divya says, I'm sorry, I have to rush now. I have to pick up my son from school. Smita says, I understand. Duties come first. Divya says, well then, see you on Saturday. Goodbye. So that is the end of the conversation, dear. So this you have to write in your composition note. Now we will go on with the rules and regulations to write a dialogue writing. Five rules of dialogue writing. There are a number of rules to keep in mind if you want to use dialogue well in your writing. So what are the five rules? We will see that dialogue should reflect your character's background. Exactly. Yes. If a smiley person or a pleasant person is writing a dialogue writing, then he will use the words, very pleasant words, very kind words, very positive words. If an angry bird is writing a dialogue, then the dialogues will be very angry and it will be very powerful. Okay, so dialogue will reflect. Ultimately, it will reflect. Anyway, dialogue should reflect your character's background. Not your character, baby, but the character of the particular what? Play or a film. To get dialogue right, you must understand how your character speak. Okay, how that particular character works. This is likely influenced by where they come from. Their social class, upbringing, and myriad other factors. So, for example, in a film, two characters are there. Okay, one comedian and one hero. Both of them are talking. So, how will you write a dialogue for a comedian and how will you write a dialogue for a hero? Do you think both the dialogues will have the same characteristic? No, isn't it? A comedian will talk very funny. A hero will talk little bit serious. Speech and tone are always bound up in what has happened and is happening to your character. So William Shakespeare was exceptionally deft at encoding his character speech patterns with these social markers and for blending these idioms within a single place. So he is the very best example for using the dialogue writing properly in his stories or poems. Next point, first point is, what is the first point? Dialogue should reflect your character's background. The next point is, be true to the period. If you are setting your story in the past, your dialogue should accurately reflect word choice, idioms, and speech pattern of that period. Okay? If you are using the character in the present, then how we are talking, the character should reflect that. If you are going to write in the future, okay, then the characters and dialogue too should reflect like a robot or whatever character you are assuming. So that is very important. Words and clothes also, dressing sense, like clothes go in and out of style, right? Conversation need to be specific to the time you are writing and without seeming contrived. So, children, I'm finishing with this slide. We'll meet in the next session, dear. And Thank you so much.